It turns out that technology is a resource liberating force that has a chance to change our world. So in Abundance, I talk about the story of this man, Napoleon III, who invites this guy, the King of Siam, over for dinner in 1840 to the Palace of Versailles. And to show his amazing capabilities, Napoleon feeds all of his troops with silver utensils. Napoleon himself eats with gold utensils, but the King of Siam, the royal guest, he's fed with aluminum utensils. Because in 1840, aluminum was the scarcest metal on the planet. Even though the Earth is made 8.3% aluminum by weight, you can't actually go and dig it out of the ground. It's all bound by oxides and silicates to literally create bauxite. And it was so energetically difficult to extract the aluminum from the bauxite, it was worth more than platinum and gold, which, by the way, is the reason the tip of the Washington Monument is capped with aluminum. It was built in that same decade. And then the technology of electrolysis came along and made it so easy to remove aluminum from bauxite. We literally use it for aluminum foils, aluminum cans, aluminum airplanes, everywhere. And if you think about the analogy of technology taking that which was scarce and making it abundant, I think about it in these ways. We live on a world, we talk about energy scarcity, we live on a world that is bathed in 5,000 times more energy than we consume as a species in a year. It's about making that energy available. And by the way, the cost of solar has dropped 50% last year, 50% the year before. We're increasing our production rates globally by 30%. And if we have abundant energy, a squanderable amount of abundant energy, then water is not an issue. You know, we talk about water scarcity and water wars. We live on a water planet, the pale blue dot. You know, two-thirds of our surface is water. Yes, 97.5% is salt water, 2% of the polar caps, and we fight over 0.5%. But the same way that we learn to extract aluminum from bauxite, so shall we the water from our oceans. There's amazing work being done by Dean Kamel with the slingshot technology. The chairman of Coca-Cola, Muhtar Kent, is committed to helping take that technology globally. Breakthroughs in nanomaterials will give us a world of abundant water. This Maasai warrior on a cell phone has better mobile comm than President Clinton did when he was in office. And if he's on, literally, on Google, on an Android phone, he's got access to more knowledge and information than President Bush did. On something that they're microfinancing, with a set of applications that literally give them extraordinary video teleconferencing, GPS, HD cameras, for no cost.